It's camera from camera colors, powerful color, excuse me, camera from cameras coloring heaven. Anyways, I am here to do a flip through of something I got today at Walmart. And I got this today at Walmart, and I thought it was cheaper at Walmart than on Amazon, but it's actually the same price. But this is one that I've been wanting, and I really didn't see much to do on YouTube to do with a flip through. I saw it's like a one, I think. But I thought I'd do one myself. Now this is a pretty good sized book and also kind of thick too. It's horror, glow in the dark coloring, illustrated by, and I'm betting they're related, Juan and Santiago Calle, or Calle. That's the front. I love the pictures in here. I don't really have many to do with horror. And this is the back that says, "Are you fascinated by fear? Gripped by all things gory? Then this is the coloring book for you. Horror fans will be entranced and enraptured by the scenes inside. Pick up your pen and prepare to create something, some spellbinding. Prepare to create, excuse me, to create some spellbinding work of art with an added eerie element of glow-in-the-dark pages. Marvel at the extraordinary work of the talented artist of the Librem Donum Studio. They have created an astonishing array of horror tablets. All that's needed is for you to add your own personal touches, then turn off the lights and watch the scene transform with their special supernatural natural glow." Sorry, my mouth is a little dry. Effective. Okay, I'm gonna open up the book. Yeah, my fingers would cooperate with me. Okay. Kind of thick cover too. Got a real thick cover. Horror, glow in the dark. And I don't know if you can notice it on here, but the parts that glow, you can feel they're raised up off the paper. I'm not too sure what it is they use, but you can feel it. It kind of a little raised up off the paper. But so far on this one, it's the skulls. That looks like his brains coming out, his teeth, nose, eyes. And on here, it looks like the ground and I think those are horns, I think. And the horns up here, the lady's arms, and more horns. Okay. And it's Thunder Bay Press, San Diego, California, that they published this at. That one, I don't know why. You know what this one puts in mind of? That painting of the Scream. I can't remember who does it, but the painting of the Scream for some reason. And there's six pages too. They are on both sides though. I really like this one. I like this one a lot. Now imagine opening the door to that. That would freak me out. Sleep paralysis. I've had that at times, I swear to God, and it's the worst feeling of all. Sleep paralysis. It's like something's holding you down and you cannot get up. And I'm not sure what being a fishbowl or something. I'm not sure what that's about. Under the bed. Cool. Okay, I'm taking it. Those are teeth. That's blood dripping down. Okay. Like I said, I've never really done horror that much. That one was wild. I guess he brushed his teeth. He probably does it because he's a monster. Barracuda? I think that's what they call them, barracudas. I really like this one. This one kind of puts me in mind of, I think it was about 10 years or maybe ago, or a little longer than that. There is a movie called The Crow, and it's a different one than it's got Brendan Lee in it. This is got Kirsten Dunst in it, but there's a part in the movie where she gets her eyes sewn shut and her lips sewn shut because some bad guy got a hold of her. And it shows there towards the end where she has to literally take a scalpel and cut them out. I'd be like, oh my God, the pain. Now this one I do like. I think this is really neat. I really like this. And I like this, even though I hate snakes with a passion, I do. I hate them. I like to collar them because it gives me a chance to practice their scales. And I think they're supposed to be nice. I think. I'm gonna see if I can get these pictures kind of aligned. Oh, deer. I love deer. Now this is cool. I like that. I like these too. I'm not big on the background, but I like these too. That looks like a cat and dog fighting. I think it's a Venus flytrap capturing souls, I think. Kind of like that one too. That was kind of cool. Wolfman! Reminds me of Werewolf in London. I love that song. Now there's something I would never ever want to come out of my mouth. Oh my God, I don't like spiders. I don't like creepy crawlies. This is kind of neat. I love the giraffe. Ah, Dr. Jekyll and Dr. Hyde. I like this. That is so cool. I love that. I like this, but I do not like the background. I'm not big on the background. Oh, wow. If that wasn't there to glow, that would be neat to make a red. That, and also have a red spot. Reminds me of Jigsaw from the Saw movies. Those movies freak me out. I love them, but they freak me out just when you think it can't get any more psychotic. They do. These are kind of neat. I like this. This puts me in mind of, I read the book a long time ago, and I've seen the movie Abraham Lincoln Vampire Slayer or Hunter like that. This reminds me of a scene that was in Take That Back. It's still by Seth Green, but it was Pride, Prejudice, and Zombies. I read the book, but the book was so much better than the movie. This is what's reminding me of it. Ooh, I love that. And I like this. I like that a lot. Ah, zombies and brains. Zombie Cinderella with I want to say this reminds, oh, it's about a train. Heather Portsmouth. Okay, drive-in Cinderella. Zombie Cinderella. I like this, but I do not like the background. Too detailed. I like this one. And nothing on it that goes in the dark. This one's pretty cool. This is the, yeah, that's the cover. A vampire. Two vampires. Oh, this is cool. I like this. Now this one I can handle. This, I've already got ideas about it too. See, the pages are pretty thick. The zombies are trying to get out. That makes my head hurt even worse just looking at that. This is cool. This I could do too. It's pretty cool. I like this. Another werewolf. Werewolf and London. I really don't know what that is. But it reminds me of, there's a movie that came out a few years ago, the Something in the Water, that's of this lady that she falls in love with this sea creature, and she's trying to get it to, she's trying to save it at the end to try to get it out of this laboratory. It's a kind of a weird movie. It's one you have to really stick with in order to understand it. And these pages are perforated too, I noticed. Okay, for some reason, these are reminding me of Khaleesi's dragons from Game of Thrones. Okay, that's pretty cool. Oh wow, I like this. This reminds me, I don't know if you've ever seen it, seen him. There is a guy that's actually in real life, and I think he performs at circuses, but I think they call him the Lizard Man, that actually he has actually had horn implants in his forehead, he's got his tongue split, he's had his teeth sharpened, he's had tattoos on him from the top of his head to the bottom of his feet. To look like scales. He wanted to look like a lizard. He's even had his eyes done up like that. I was like, oh my god. And this is pretty cool too. Okay. This actually is a book that's actually printed in the UK. But that is it. I hope you guys liked the review, and if you do, go down below, hit subscribe, click on the like button, and also the bell for notifications for when I have more videos come out. Bye-bye.